This morning, I'm here at the Art of Disney in downtown Disney in Walt Disney World, sitting with a true master of his craft and a person that has brought delight and wonder and amazement to Disney fans from across the world. And his work on miniature figures and sculptures and scenes of Disney characters and theme parks is extraordinary. And today he is releasing and signing his latest creation. So join me to discuss some of his background and his work on Disney sculptures is Mr. Robert Olszewski. Olszewski, welcome to the WDW Radio.
Oh, thanks for having me. Really appreciate it.
It's wonderful to have you here. I enjoy your work. I own much of your work. And if I had more room, I would probably have many more of your pieces. But we'll get to some of the theme park miniatures first.
I did my first carving in November of 1977. I'd never carved. You know, I took sculpture in school. But I looked for 4 years on how to work in a small scale. And I was at a party up the street, and the guy that had this party was a dentist. And we got to talking about carving his patient's teeth out of wax and casting them. I said, "You mean to tell me I can take a piece of wax and cast?" And he said, "Yeah." And he gave me a piece of wax about the size of a 50-cent piece. And I went down home. It was November 77. I did my first carving with a nail and a screwdriver. I would heat that screwdriver in a flame and carve the wax. And I went to our shop teacher to cast it because he was doing brass castings for his clocks. He was restored clocks. And I went to a local jeweler and he lost wax cast these for me. And by, that was November 77. And I finished that school year, and I never went back.
Tell us a little bit about this piece, when it came out, and maybe some of your work, and some of the details on here.
Well, one of the big things in this one is, generally, you won't see these pieces opened up through the center. You know, usually they're solid. It saves cost. A piece like this, without exaggerating, could probably have 100 different molds on it, and more. Because you've got, each one of these is a part. And the trouble with designing at this scale and with this complexity is because you break that little flag, the piece is a reject. To design at this scale is really risky with this kind of detail. It's much safer to not dot the I's on it. But I figured, you know, I'm only going to get this one shot at it. It's going to be my castle. So I'm going to do everything I can to make it right. I will take artistic license, and I compacted the stage. You know, because right now there's this big staircase going up there for the shows. So I take license there.
What I would love to do, if it's okay with you, is I'd love to walk around the gallery, look at some pieces, definitely showcase some of your work.
These are wonderful for so many different reasons. Again, you know, we love to bring home artwork and hang it on the wall. Sometimes we don't have room for some of the miniatures. These are affordable. They have great classic scenes from Disney films, some theme park attractions. And again, you get that sense of such a depth of feel to them because of how they're laid out and because of the lighting. And if you want to get 10 of them, you can fit them on a shelf. You don't have to build something for them.
You go back into the wall. So these accents of color and depth. And then summer, you know, this one I did, this is a lot of fun, Lady and the Tramp. What I like about this, you get to see the gloves hanging in the back. And maybe you're going down, you know, 200 feet down the alley.
And there's so much to explore looking at it. And as you change the angles of it, and again, you're capturing these iconic scenes from classic films. I'm so happy that you picked up Tinkerbell from my favorite Peter Pan.
And see, now this is I did for characters then. Here she is sitting on the bookshelf. So you see the size of her in context of the books. And it's dark back there. See, I hid that light behind that book, right over there. And then look at that front shadow on the wall. Oh, and then look at the pixie dust on the wall.
I was going to say, the subtle pixie dust in the background, again, gives you something else to look at and look
to think about. Yeah, right. You come back to it. And what I want people to do is say, darn that place.
But you know, you're getting all of the requisite and the representative elements from all the films. And now you've all started to carry them on to some classic theme park attractions, too. And I'd be remiss if I didn't bring down Pirates of the Caribbean.
And And see, this one, in this room, it looks a little bit dark, but you get this home in a dark room, this looks just the way it should.
But that yellowish-orange light, you that's see right. it, and that's exactly what you get, though, that sort of the dark and the burning embers and everything else that you get from that scene in Pirates.
Yeah.
There's the Enchanted Tiki Room here. Is this available now?
This will be available in
September.
I did.
September 9th.
I mean, look at that. Isn't that so fun?
That's bad.
Yeah, but it was fun. It's so fun. So, that's how bad it is. I mean, so the ride's freaking technical. It's great Disney Paris. And
are you a long time collector or a first time collector?
Long time.
What kind of community is it?
Miniatures, we have a little box in the boxes and then
So you really are a long time.
Yes,
you were three Disney.
I'm working on Fantasyland.